Hi everyone. So in this video, we are specifically going to talk about Webpack and Babel. These are totally separate topics, but we are using them to compile our code. So coming back to our code here, we understood npm, how it works. We actually wrote this package.json and how we can add a new packages. We can just simply npm install minus minus save package name. This is how we can add a new package, npm. So you can define packages inside a dev dependency or dependencies. I have a React and React DOM as a dependencies because these are core. Dev dependencies, these are needed only to create a build, not for the production application when we need to deploy the application. So that's why these are in the dev dependencies. Okay, you can install any package with this command, and to write scripts, there is a script tag where you can just add the whatever you want it to do, like test. This is a new script I have added, and I can say echo hello. Right, so this is a new script I have created. So how you can run it? Npm run test. This will do echo hello, right? Similarly, we are doing npm run build. It is actually running the build in the production mode, Webpack build. Okay, now coming back to our point, what is this Babel? Babel is actually a compiler, or you can say transpiler, which is compiling this JSX plus ES6 code to ES5, which you can see in the dist folder. This code browser can understand because this is written in literally ES5. Everything is a function, as you can see. It's not readable code because it's minified. Let me see if I can format it and see. I can't, because this is minified, right? And you can see the React code here. Version, this is the version, this is the old React library, which is minified and compressed, and we are using it. And somewhere we are using our component, which is also might be minified. Still, I can try to search it and we'll try to see. And I found it. This is my component. Okay, you can see my component, how it is created. You can see these functions, render, create element, render. So where does this my JSX goes, where the HTML content goes? That has been converted to this react.create element, right? Every div. So this is actually what Babel is doing. It is transforming these JSX tags to the create element. You can write, I mean, very big HTML chunk here. It will get converted like the same. I will show you the simple example. Right, and if I run the build again, and I will just don't override it, and I will look at this. So this is my new main.js created. It will be a little bigger. You can see the things now. It has created all the divs to react.create element, right? We will see how the Babel is compiling these JSX tags to react.create element, where the first argument is a tag name, second argument is an attribute, third argument is a children inside it. Okay, leave it. If you're not able to understand, that's not required for now. So we actually talked about Babel. So what we need to install Babel is, we need all these packages. You can just copy paste them. Npm install Babel core, Babel loader, Babel preset. And for Webpack, we need Webpack, Webpack CLI, Webpack dev server. And you just get all the latest packages when you do it from npm install. So what Webpack is doing is, Webpack is providing us this Webpack config through which I can actually compile this React component. Whatever the big application you write, obviously there will be a single entry point, means a single file which you will be writing as a index.js, app.js, root.js, where you will be rendering all your whole the application, right? There will be one root component, and that will have n number of children components. So you, whatever the application you write, there will be one root component that will be the entry point for your Webpack config. So Webpack config is like a computer. It is taking your React component with a JSX, ES6. It has some modules to process it. So it is using these Babel loader, CSS loader, file loader, fonts loader, image loader, URL loader. All these loaders will actually help to transform the data inside your whole React application into respective outputs. Okay, like this is JS file and you have a JSX and ES6. And here we are using Babel loader. This is the definition of Babel loader. it will compile this JSX plus ESX code back to ES5. This is what Babel loader is doing. Another thing is CSS loader or style loader, CSS loader, SAS loader. What they will do, they will take care of compiling this .css files to respective output files and will give you the final bundle file, something like this, right? So that is what Webpack is doing. So Webpack is taking the help from these loaders, Babel loader, CSS loader, file loader, URL loader, and in the whole application, it is transforming, compiling, transpiling, and giving you the final main.js, right? So Webpack is a bundler. It is managing the dependencies. It knows what modules I need to import in the final bundle. You might be using React, React Table, RC Table, React Grid, AG Grid, Kendo Grid, all these different packages in your application. But finally, what you get is single file, right? How it is managing it. It is compiling, it is picking up what modules we need from all these different libraries. So it is managing the dependencies. I already have created a nice playlist on Webpack 4. You can have a look. Okay, so once Webpack is done, what you get is main.js and index.js, and this is how we are running our application. When you do npm run start, we can see our application running, and what we are printing is this component on the UI. Right? You can see here we have these my first components, right? Simple. So this is about Webpack. We will not talking about Webpack in depth because this is not our main focus. We will be moving to Create React App. This is just to give you the quick overview how actually this JSX is getting compiled. Now, in the next video, we will understand what this JSX is getting compiled into.